Greetings and welcome back, one and all, to Dapper Dell Farm and, of course, to Stardew Valley. It is Friday, the 26th of spring. It is Pierre's birthday, and let's see what the fortune teller has to say. Spirits are somewhat annoyed today. That isn't very good. Weather report, it's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. That's actually kind of good. Okay. Right then. We are going to want some fruit for this. We'll take one rhubarb, I think. We are also then immediately going to drop off this, and then we are going to go ahead and make ourselves a couple of things. We're going to grab 15 sashimi, 5 chocolate cake. That should be good enough, I think. Also hash browns, a pancake, an omelette. What do I need for the complete breakfast? Fried egg. There we go. Boink. Ooh, I'm a sous chef! Ha-ha! Perfect. I approve of this. Quite enormously, in fact. Right, okay. Let's head on out. It is raining. The sky is crying. Hey, Aavak. I thought it would be fun to write you a note. I had so much fun with the cows yesterday. I'm starting to understand why you chose the farmer's life. Hope to see you soon, Haley. Aww. Hey kid, here's a recipe for a little treat my pappy used to make. Cook it slow. Stuffing! Very well. Okay, do we have anything to drop off? I suppose I could drop off the omelette, honestly. Didn't really mean to make that. Right. Farmer's lunch. Let us eat. Om nom nom. There we go. Right. For 50 max energy, farm. This is good. I approve of it. I have no idea how the farming buff affects anything, though. No idea whatsoever. Okay, wow, we really need to fix a lot of stuff around here. Goat's cheese. Take both of you. All of you. Let's go ahead and pop these two in there. One, two. I'm going to bring that with me. I'm going to want all three of these eggs. There we are. Right, we want to place down the keg and then the rhubarb in the keg. Okay, we really need to sort that out inventory, and I'll grab a bunch of walls to sort all of these walls out as well. We are going to want stone, we are going to want any errant walls that we may already have. Drop off the goat's cheese, the cauliflower, the apricot, and the cherry, and the mayonnaise, and the green algae as well. And the daffodils. Everything else can stay with me. Nope. Nope, nope, go away. There we are. Oh, nothing in there. Okay, fair enough. Off we go, actually. What can I make? Can't make any more of those, but I could possibly make some of those, maybe? Iron bar, I can make some more recycling machines. Need earth crystal for that, I need copper for the cheese press. Very well. Where's the wood? I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to make myself a bunch more coal once I get down there, but I can have one cheese press straight up, so I'll make one. So many messed up walls. 10 should cover it. There we go. And over hither as well. There we are. Now, how do I make a tree tap? Just copper bars, but I'm going to need to get copper for that. Okay. The alternative is I could simply go and buy copper off Clint. I have got 31,000. I should be able to handle that. Although, that being said, it may be worth my while if I actually start to hoard my hardwood instead for a house upgrade. There we go. I'm sorry, caryards, but you're going to have to stay inside today. It's raining outside. You'll probably hear it. Let's go and visit the beefs. Oh, actually, no. We don't yet have the room in my inventory for that. we go. Now, I'm going to need to bring some chests down here anyway. Simply because to move the chest down is going to take a little bit of effort. So I figured I may as well bring this down here now. I can go in there. Got one more cheese press that can go down. There we go. Perfect. And the CD as well. So that'll be a bunch of extra refined quartz. We'll drop off the eggs. Grab these two. Damn. We need a lot more wood for that. But that's the total amount of wood we needed. Right, let's have a look. Oh yeah, another preserve. I could go with that as well, actually. Sure. Let's get a little bit more. Ah, we don't have the wood now. Scallywags. Do I have any... I wonder, can I put horseradish in there? No. That is a shame. That would have been kind of cool. Let's put some eggs in there. Okay, my inventory is so messed up right now. I don't even know how to begin. Don't even know how to begin explaining it. Just completely messed up in every measurable way. We'll just be bringing those along with us. Grab the cheese. Grab the milk pail. Okay, it is 10:40. We have got a lot of work to do. So much work to do. Hello. Oh, nope. Bonnie has no milk right now. Oh, it could be that goats only produce milk every other day, much like the ducks only produce eggs every other day. Let's find out. No. Evelina, no milk. Fair enough. Let's move on. Right. Now, they are all set to... you know what? I'm going to turn off the cow's pregnancies. For now. Nope. Bill, you're not allowed to be pregnant. Nor are you, Blossom. I'm sorry. Cowlick, no pregnancy for you. Umakachu, no. If we're going to have any of them be pregnant, then it would ideally be one of the goats, as they're significantly more valuable. Oh, yeah. Now we can get 3 pieces of cheese done. Perfect. All right. That was none too bad. Didn't quite mean to take it all out, but oh well. And down there as well, and up here. Okay. Right then, we have done all I feel that we need to do today. I'll drop that off. We'll drop the mayonnaise off as well. The crayfish can go in our inventory. In the house. And then we're good. Right. Who can I give a present to? Emily can have a present. Linus can have a present. Penny can have presents. George, Marnie. Okay, there are still actually quite a few people who can be given gifts. Okay. Well, the first port of call shall be Robin's place to see if we can't start her working on a new... Oh, actually, mushrooms first. We want to get Robin working on a new... silo. That's going to be fairly cheap for us. I just realized. Oh, good. Still got the stone on us. There we are. Now that I've got the mushroom, though, I want to go quickly and make George some fried mushrooms. It's been a while since I've been able to give him his favorite meal. Actually, I don't need to worry about that. I can just do it from here. Fried mushroom. There we go. Then I can drop that off. And I may as well just top that up a little bit more. Okay, there we are. Right, so Pierre's first. I've decided that we'll go to Pierre's first instead. Because I need to give him his birthday present. And you know what? He likes daffodils, so I could just give him a daffodil. No. Birthday requires birthday cake. As much as that would be useful for me, no. Ooh, a quest. I need an eel for a calzone I'm making. Ooh. What the dickens? I'm going to Caroline's place. What on earth am I doing? I swear, I'm not like this in real life. Found Pierre's secret stash. Oh dear God. Hey, who's in the bedroom? What the hell is going on with me? Why am I such a weirdo? Wow, how did you find that? Quick, give it to me. Promise me you won't tell anyone about this. Your wife deserves to know about this. Your secret is safe with me. No one needs to know about that kind of hentai. Thanks, I appreciate that. Just forget you ever saw this, okay? And I'll just forget that you were snooping around in my bedroom. That seems like a completely fair deal, actually. Alright. Come on, now I have to find a new hunting spot. Dear God. What kind of person am I? I agree, it does look very different in the rain. It looks much more interesting. See, just going in people's bedrooms, finding their quote-unquote secret stash. A birthday gift. That's very kind of you. I love it. You're welcome, Pierre. Can we have a chat as well? Most people stay indoors on days like this. Well, that's not good for business. Oh, well. Here we are. Wow, salmon berry wine is only worth 44? Well, that is utterly rubbish. Rubbishness of the highest order, I tell you. Highest order. The very highest orders of rubbish, that is. Actually, I need to get up to Robin's place really fast before she closes. When it is a Friday, she might have actually already headed to the saloon. I just want that silo built, please. Ride like the wind, Akasha. Oh, thank goodness. Hello, Robin. I would like to construct a new silo. Oh, no, copper bars, why? Poop. On the plus side, could look again one of these. That's not actually that much. 300 stone, 550 wood, that's like a night's work in that pine forest in my farm and a day down the mine. Might be worth it, actually. And that is a lot of money. What about a house upgrade? How much would that cost? 50k? Yeah, right. That's not happening anytime soon, I can promise you. Rain doesn't stop me from getting my job done. That's because you're a good carpenter. Although soggy wood isn't a joy to work with. Yes, I can well imagine. Greetings, stay inside if you want to keep warm. Thank you. That's very, very nice of you. Would you like a daffodil? That was very thoughtful of you. I know. I'm a very thoughtful guy. Here you go, Maro. Space laser. Is that... Oh, wow, Aavak! This is spectacular! My laser is going to kill many more monsters now. Because I can't see Maro using her space laser on people. She might threaten to get the world governments to give her money, but I don't think she'd ever actually go through with it. It'd just be a bluff. Monsters, though, I suspect she'd be alright with using it on monsters. Though, she may take liberties with the definition of monster. I'm just saying, if you really push her, don't be too surprised when suddenly there's a beautiful bright light above your house, and then your house is gone. You along with it. Now I've got to find George. Hello, George. Dun-dun-dun. My favorite thing, thank you. You're welcome. My grandpap was a farmer. It's a respectable profession. I wasn't so darned old, I'd come to your farm and show you a thing or two. I'm sure you'd be able to show me quite a lot. There's no good weather for sports. I don't know, it depends on the sport, really. I have no plants to give you. Well, scallywags. You like a chocolate cake? This is cool, thanks. You're welcome. Now then, we need to go and see Corbus, because Corbus has got a very special something that I want. Corbus! I need your iridium sprinklers! Some people have said are radioactive. They're not! Iridium isn't naturally radioactive. You can make it radioactive, but then you can make yourself radioactive if you apply the right sort of science to you. Don't worry, I'm not watering my crops with radioactive sprinklers. Hey, Leah. Maybe I should cook something new and exciting today. Something spicy. I'm a big fan of spicy food. Hi, Lewis. Good evening, Aavak. I'm glad to see you relaxing at the saloon. It's good for you to take a break now and then. Your grandfather always worked himself too hard. There we are. Thanks, this is great. You're very welcome. Let's go and chat with both Gus and Emily. Business has been really good tonight. I'm pleased. It never rains in Calico Desert. That's where my friend Sandy lives. Let's go and see if Sam and Sebastian are over here. No, but Abigail is. Hey, Abby. Fairly certain I can't give you anything more. No, I cannot. So close, though. I've got four people now. Leah is at 10 hearts. Well, that was kind of sneaky. I guess I just talked to her enough, I suppose. Abigail and Elliot are only one heart off. Caroline is only one heart off. That would give me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I need to get Linus or Haley or George or Rasmodius or Penny up to 10, I think, for the having 8 friends at 10 heart level achievement thingamajig. I'm fairly certain I've given you all of the gifts I can, Shane, I'm afraid. Hello, guys. If you really want to get the fish biting, make sure you put some bait on your hook. Indeed. If you're lucky, you might see a frog in this weather. I really love this, how do you know? It's because you told me. I'm not going to pretend there's anything else. You literally told me. You are so forgetful. Almost as forgetful as me. Almost. Not quite there, but... Clam. I wonder if Elliot's in this house. It's locked. If Elliot is in there, Elliot doesn't want to be disturbed. Go grab this. Go grab this. Oh, actually, you might talk to me now. Old Mariner. Ah, I can see it in your eyes. There be a special someone in your heart. Just so happens I'm selling a mermaid's pendant. Give that to your intended and they'll know exactly what you mean. Sure. I will hold on to this for now. Team Leah hasn't won by virtue of being the first of 10 hearts. No. Aavak is not that easy. Gotta try a little bit harder than that. Not much, perhaps. I mean, it is Leah, after all. She's lovely by default. But can't just win by being the first. That would just be too random. Also, I've been thinking about this. I've been deeply surprised by Haley's transformation. Deeply overjoyed, actually. She's really, really turned around the last couple of like little cutscenes, and it's made me realize that maybe I'm just not giving you a chance, Penny. The raindrops are really loud on the metal roof of our trailer. It's soothing, though. See, that's lovely. You're not being all mopey. Here you go. You just needed a good rain. I'll accept this. Thank you. Oh, you're blushing a little bit. That's sweet. I didn't know you felt the same. Oh, wow. My heart just melted. I may actually be in need of medical assistance. Literally, it's leaking out of the pores of my skin. I'm probably going to die soon. That actually did make my chest feel tighter for a second there as well. Wow. Right, well, let's get back to the farm. We will drop off the clams and various other bits and bobs that we just picked up. Got these off as well. Got this to give to Leah, as soon as I can give anything to Leah. We've got the mermaid panda. That needs to go in the house. That does not need to be out here. No, no, no. In you go. I'm probably going to try and use those to sort out some of... sorry, not sort them out, but get some more wines, because clearly the salmon berry, just not worth it. Not worth it at all. Maybe use the salmon berry for other things, but absolutely not worth making preserves and stuff out of. Strawberry jelly might be okay, though. There we go. And this as well. There we are. Now, the first iridium sprinkler is going to go over here. And as it happens, it needs to be 1, 2, 1, 2, so right along here. And we'll start from this side. There we go. It's not... We're probably not going to put... Well, we are absolutely not going to plant anything there. There's no point. But what I will do is go and grab myself... two more fruits to use down there. I'm thinking... I could use those two melons. I'm not sure I should, though. I'll be honest with you. I'll use the two cactus... No, I'll use one crystal fruit and a cactus fruit. That's what I'll use. Now, with the remaining energy and time that we have tonight, I think the best thing for us to do would be to chop down a load of wood. We're a little bit off now being able to upgrade our chicken coop, but that's fine for the time being, because we are going to need crazy amounts of seeds for the new season anyway, so we don't actually want to spend all my money. I was very close to making that mistake. I'm really glad that I... Oh my god. I'm fairly certain that we're being invaded. This is an invasion force. Anyone who can't see that is probably a sympathizer. Okay, there we go. I have more or less finished cutting this entire area back. At least down to here, where we'll be able to use this area then for the path. But I'll have to bring that down first. But we'll do that later, because it is almost time for me to collapse. And I don't want to collapse today. I just want to get home. I want to jump in bed. And I want to be all safe and snug. Of course, I'm going to stop to be greedy. And this is going to come and bite me back. In the bum. No, oh, come on. I catch it. Run. Run like the wind. 40. I might be able to make it. If it turns 50 just outside, I'll be alright. Go. 1, 2. What else was it? 3. Run. Got 7 seconds to get to bed. 7. Very short seconds to get to bed. Now go. Take that. Ah, I shouldn't have been greedy. But I'm glad that I made it. Ooh, the goat cheese made quite a lot. So did the duck mayonnaise, mind you. Very nice. Regular mayonnaise, okay. Okay, very nice indeed. 6,850. That's not too bad. Now, I believe it's going to be Emily's birthday today. Okay, let's double check. Yes, Emily's birthday today. Hooray! Let's check on the weather report and the fortune teller. Spirits are very happy today. That is very good. Weather report. It is going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Hurrah! Okay, let's drop off anything I really want to drop off, which is actually nothing. Don't want to drop off anything today. Okay, well, in that case, I'm going to make some more rhubarb pie. Let's go! I should actually make myself another farmer's lunch, but, breakfast. Aavak, I'm going to give you this advice because I like you, and I want you to stay in Pelican Town. If there comes a day that you want to ask for someone's hand in marriage, you'll need to give them a mermaid's pendant. Don't worry. Everyone in Pelican Town understands the significance of the amulet. It's an ancient tradition in this region. Good luck. Wow, word gets around fast. Like, scary fast. Word shouldn't be able to get around that fast, frankly. Someone is spying on me, and I think I know who. Bloody Rasmodeus. Alright, let's drop these off. I just don't have enough copper, so I'm not going to need to get copper. So we're probably going to have to head to the caves today. Bit of a pain, but oh well. We have some honey, thankfully. Beehives have been so nerfed. They produce honey far less frequently these days. But oh well. Again, I still kind of agree with it. I'll have to repair those later. Okay, come with me. Oh well, it doesn't actually matter. Thankfully, that wasn't a crop. My lord, accidental murder by pickaxe. Okay, well, these are not going to be ready in time. Very sad, very sad. We are going to get a decent harvest out of everything else, Ed. Though, we were probably going to start the next season with a lot of money. And this top field is entirely going to be a cash crop. So, probably blueberries. All of this will be blueberries. And all of the bottom field will probably be melons to start off with. Okay, that's pretty good. Let's go and drop off some of these. Because they're bound to be clogging up my inventory. We'll drop off all of those. Which ones do we drop? Well, actually, no. Drop off these ones. As for the rhubarb, sure. Anything else? No, I think we're good, actually. All right. Off we go. We'll drop these off straight away. Drop that one off, that one off. Does anything actually use strawberries? Because if it does, it probably doesn't matter. And I'm only getting an extra 5 out of it. So I'll sell the ones that are going to get me the greater profit for now. We are going to need to pick up my stone again, though, because there's so many walls that need to be repaired. Come the end of the season, always seems to be the larger number of walls need fixing, unfortunately. There we go. Close that. There we are. Down here as well. I knew that was going to happen eventually. I'm keeping some things on me just because I want to go to Pierre's and give the crops to him direct. Let's grab you. Ooh, we've actually got 3 actual catches today. The periwinkles can go into my fridge. Now, the reason why I keep the periwinkles and all of those is because they all count as fish. So any fish meal can just be made of anything I get from the crab pots. No. Let's go back to this. There we go. And unfortunately, this is going to be the last time we get anything from these ones. Alas. It does seem that certain things have been nerfed a little bit. Now, these crops will all be made into trellis crops in summer, which I believe are hops for the summer trellis crops. Then we will be turning all of the field over there into blueberries. The lower field will all be turned into melons for the first harvest. Not sure what we'll do for the second harvest. I do kind of want to spread them out. I'm going to have at least a little bit of wheat, though. Because we need that for one of the bundles. But the melons I mostly want for the bundle, but they are actually a very valuable crop as well. So they'd be good as a cash crop. Simply because of their high individual value. There you go. Snufkin! Where are you? There we go. Anything broken behind here? Of course there's going to be something broken behind here. There's always going to be broken things behind here. There we go. Right, time to gather up some eggs. Let's move all of these off my inventory for now. So I can freely gather the eggs. And you can all come out today. Hello. Haven't been getting any nice large eggs, or at least not many large eggs anymore. I wonder why, because for a time that was the majority of the things we were getting. But all of a sudden, they've gone back down. It might have been a couple of those days where they just weren't allowed out properly. Or I left the door open, and it just seemed to put them off. I should have grabbed the milk pail while I was down here last time. Drat. Oh well. There we go. No duck eggs today, though. Almost left without the milk pail. I think we should get some goat's milk today, though. Which would be very nice. The grass is growing nicely in this area. Hello, my lovelies. There we go. Now. Thank you very much, Bonnie. We've got half a heart with Bonnie. Sorry about that. I must be wringing my hands ridiculously tightly in order to make that sound. With empty air. My lord. But there we go. 2 goat's milk, 4 cow milk. That should do as well. Enjoy! Now let's get down here. We'll start off with the goat's milk. Oh, actually, we've got 3 of them, so... We'll start off with the goat's milk, but we'll move on and finish off with the cow's milk later. Alright. And we've got 1 more wall we need to place. There we go. Perfect. Now, Akasha. Let's head into town. Got a good amount of money. We're not going to be getting rid of that money, so we'll just stick that out. We'll go see Leah after that as well, if we can. Saturday, so I can't give anyone any more gifts, but I can at the very least talk to people. Nope, no one in there. Ooh. Hello. Things changed a lot after the Jojo Mart went up. It's been really bad for Pierre's shop. Mum loves Jojo Mart, though. The prices are cheap, so she can afford a lot more there than she ever could at Pierre's. Well, that makes sense, but can I not talk to anyone else? Miss Penny makes me read a new book every week. At least she lets me pick them sometimes. Jazz. Sometimes I look for crawdads in the river. Don't tell Aunt Marnie, but occasionally I feed them to the Count. And Aunt Marnie. She never notices me stick them into the soup. Everyone seems a little happier on the weekends, don't you think? Yes, actually. Can I give you anything to this? No. Alas. I can, however, pop my head in here. Hello, Caroline. Okay, you're not talking to me. Hello, Abby. You came all this way to visit me? That's nice. Yes, I did. So, have you been exploring the mountain caves at all? Yeah, actually, not recently. Interesting. I'd like to go there myself one of these days. I'm sure you'll get a chance. I don't think I can give you anything. No, I can't. Oh well. If you find any wild produce, I'll take it off your hands for a reasonable price. Very well. You can also take my non-wild produce off my hands, too. I did actually mean to put those somewhere else, but never mind. You can have these two. You can have... No, you can't have my robot pad. They're mine. Nothing else. Ooh. Dark color flooring? Yeah, sure, I'll take that. You know what? I'm also going to buy this wallpaper, and I'm going to stick it in a chest. I don't think I'm ever going to use that wallpaper. It's far too bright. But I might stick it somewhere. Where is Emily? I have a birthday present. There you are, Emily. I've been growing this diamond for you. Here you go. You remember my birthday? Thank you. This is great. You're welcome. I like making my own clothes, but it's not easy to get cloth. It's such a long trip to the city. I know. Can be suckful. No point in me going looking for Elliot. I still can't give him a present to make up for the terrible present I gave him before. Ooh. Oh! Hi, Aavak. I knew you'd be passing through here today. Is this the fabled salad you've been telling me you'll make me for ages? So I put together a surprise. Aww. It's a little picnic just for us. This is lovely. This is a vegetable medley with my special spice blend. You listened to me when I said I like spicy food. Aww. This is a fresh salad made from greens that I forage right here in the forest. And this table made from driftwood. I just want to say thank you. for helping me get one step closer to becoming a real artist. You were always a real artist, Leah. Oh, distant voice. Well, well, well. Actually, distant voice.
Well, well, well. What have we here?
A picnic. Is it not obvious? Kel? Oh, dear. That name rings a bell. What the heck are you doing here? Didn't you see me at the art show? I came all the way from Zuzu City to see your sculptures. And to get... Yeah, and get you to come back with me. I want things to go back the way they were. I miss you, babe. I have a completely unreasonable... adverse reaction to anyone who uses the term babe. And it is completely unreasonable. Yuck, don't call me that. Seems Leah shares this unreasonable reaction. It is unreasonable, though. It's just a term of endearment. Some people like it, some people don't. But I don't know, it makes my skin crawl a bit. You've never supported my art before. Now that I've had some success, you want me back? You make me sick. Oh, wow. Hey, come here. Oh, wait now. Punch Cal in the face or try punch. That is also unreasonable. I mean, yeah, babe made my skin crawl, but I'm not about to like lay him down on the floor. I mean, it might be annoying, but that's not a justification. Just a weighed in fists flailing. Try to reason with him. I have nothing to say to you. Get out of my way. Oh, I just get out of the way. I actually would have stood there, but... Seriously, Leah. What are you doing out here with this simple-minded... Simple-minded bumpkin? What? Okay. Fair enough. Violence out the window. Aavak's better man than you in every respect. Haha, take that! Now get out of here. Never come back. Wow. Let's go, Aavak. I don't think Kel will be bothering us anymore. Is he alright, though? I would actually like to make sure you didn't, like, smash his nose across his face. Let's find a more secluded spot this time. You were. Well, that was unexpected. You're very sweet. Leah defended my honor. Well, the picnic didn't pan out like I wanted it to. That's okay. You're awesome. I still stand by my decision not to hit him, though. As funny as it was when she hit him. If the local fishing scene got a bit more lively, I might expand the shop stock. You say that all the time. I think you're lying to me. You know what? Let's go and see Rasmodeus. Oh, actually, no. I've given Rasmodeus everything. Damn it! Why have I given everyone every present I possibly can? You know what? I can go and talk to Marnie. Hello, Marnie. Have you been to the strange tower west of my house? Yes, I have. The fellow there is... Well, he's a bit of a creep. I mean that in the sense that he does creep, but... You know, I think he's just unfamiliar with the ways of regular people. He's too long in his own tower, huffing fumes from that weird green bubbling cauldron. Is Penny up here? Hey, Penny. It has been far too long. Thank you. This looks special. You're welcome. Hey, Haley. Yesterday I found a seagull with her wing caught in a net. I set her free, of course. She looked so helpless, the poor thing. Oh, that's really sweet. Now, we're gonna need a lot more stone if I want to do anything with building up my farm. So, let's take this opportunity where we've really got nothing else to do today to go to the mine instead and gather up some stone. Also some copper. Desperately need the copper. I'll be back in a bit, Akasha. Let's check out the quarry first. Hello, quarry. Are there any gems? No. Then I don't care too much. We're going to go down to the mine. I'll get more out of the mine. Ooh, you know what? I haven't been to the dwarf in ages. I'll get more out of the mine than I will out of the quarry. By far. Here you go. I'm sorry I don't stop by to talk to you. There was a time when I came to the mine like every chance I had. But these days, it's a little bit different. Oh, someone's actually mentioned that there's a way to get lower than floor 120. I think they're yanking my crank, pulling my chain. Let's see. No, no, you lied to me, you did. Oh, you scallywags. I don't expect that from my comments. Leading me astray like this. Right. Well, let's grab a load of stone. Also, a hermit crab, apparently. Now, we're mostly here to gather the stone. So, that's going to be my focus. I will kill everything on the level as well. Oh, dear. Don't evolve. There we go. Monster Slayer! Goal complete! I've completed a goal! It's fantastic! Okay, well, I guess my mining day today is going to be cut short. I'm going to go straight back and see Gil. After I gather that stone. Take me home! I mean, to Gil. I'm not sure when the Adventurers Guild closes. Aha! Hello, Gil. Insect head. Not very pleasant to wield. 10 to 20. That's not. Really? Really, really? Because. I feel a tad bit disappointed. I'll be honest. A tad bit. Oh, wow. I'm going to sell this stuff. That's actually not bad. I could even buy one of these at this point. I don't really want any of those, though. Let's see what else I'm close to. So I've done the cave insects. I'm way off on the duggies. Not that far off on skeletons. Crazy far off on most of these things, actually. Oh well. Off we go. Back to the mines. Right. Let us jump down. We've got a good 6 hours. We should be fine. Let's go back down to level 25, because again, I want to have some copper. Ouch. Damn it. Ooh, geodes. I approve of these. I've always got loads of food that I can use to top up my energy levels as well, so it's fine. But we're going to need 5 copper bars to make myself a... Or rather, have Robin make for me a silo. And I really do feel that now that we're expanding the barn and the chicken coop, by winter, I aim to have the fully expanded and fully filled barn and chicken coop. So we're going to need a lot of hay over the winter. So I'm going to need to work on that now rather than later. Oh, did I get you as well? I did, it seems. Very well. It's another Dougie. There we go. I really should upgrade this. One of these days. Cave carrot. Always worth having. Make the miners treat with that, I believe. Oh, hello. No. Well, that worked out for me, I guess. I wanted another one of them. Ooh, a skeletal tail. I think we've already had that one. Yeah. Oh well. Down to the next level. I could use that bomb actually to speed things up a little bit. I think I will. It's about there. There we go. Really doesn't matter if they hit me at this point. My armor is so much higher than the level of this part of the dungeon. Of the mine, rather. I can just let them attack me. Just tank the damage. I don't actually like it when games do that. I prefer it when games have... The weaker enemies are always a threat that you can never completely just forget about them. Let's see. I mean, if in Dark Souls, I could just start running through an area and just not bother with the low-level enemies, it wouldn't feel like Dark Souls. I mean, to a degree, you can start to worry about them less, especially if you build your character in a very specific way. But you have to make certain sacrifices to achieve that. There we go. Another cave carrot. That is good. And what about down here? Not too bad. Not too good either. I wouldn't mind getting some more geodes, honestly, but... I think we're due another geode run to Clint. But I might wait until the next time I've gone down into the Skull Cavern. I may do that on the last day of spring, honestly. Because that's a pretty good time to just cut loose. Because there's nothing I'm going to need to do with watering or anything even remotely close to that. And damn it. I'm going to eat this. Go ahead. Nom. Just to give me a tiny bit more energy. Because I want to finish this floor before we leave. It's 10:40, so I'm not going to go down to the next one. I need to still find that bloody dwarf scroll, though. That's frustrating me. You know what? I will duck my head down. There might be something right in front of me. Yep, there was. Awesome. Can't pick those up, though. Guess we could maybe push my luck a little bit. Just a little, though. Some more stones. A load of stone down there, though, which is good. Some coal. Always happy to accept that. Okay, it is now time to leave. I'm not going to push my luck any further than, like, 12. Okay, we got down to level 27. And off we go back to the bus stop. Thank you for waiting, Akasha. Right, well, let's first stop off here, drop off all the things that we don't want to keep with us, which would include the artifact and this one, since we already have everything for it. Yeah, the white algae can go as well. All of this can be stowed. We'll drop off the bug meat, the slime. Cave carrots can come elsewhere with me. Clay, copper. Okay, at this point we can actually get 3 bars, which is worth it. I did also want to drop these off as well. Okay, thank you. One star, Kasha. Can't pop those in there, which is a bit of a shame. Miner's treat. There we go, I'll just make one. Perfect. I'll use that for mining when I go down into the Skull Cavern, I think. We'll drop these off. That flooring, though, I think I'm going to use it. Pop. Different coloured flooring for the bedroom. And then to bed. Well, I mean, except for Cal showing up and being a bit of a jerk, today was a lovely day. In a way, he kind of made it an even more lovely day because Leah, you know, sorted him out. I think that gave some closure that was... possibly needed on that relationship. I don't know. Okay, well, today is a new day. And in fact, it is the last day of spring. Tomorrow will be the first day of summer. And we will be finding out what I get to plant on the first day of summer. Probably in the next episode. I hope you've enjoyed this one, though. And will be joining me for the next. But until then, do take care, everyone.